Okay, so we've found the profit maximizing quantity. Now how do we find the overall level of profits? And I'm going to shift from a numerical table to a graphical example. Because in a numerical table, you'll just be able to read the total amount of profits directly off there as profits equals total revenue minus total costs. And instead, I'm going to say we're going to do this graphically. And in this graphical version of it, we're going to rely on the other way of thinking about profits, which is that profits are the price you sell your stuff for minus the average cost of production times the number of units you sold. So, I'm going to go back to our simple monopolist example here, and this monopolist is going to have a constant marginal cost, and is going to have average total costs that look like this, because they are spreading their fixed costs over more and more units, so that average total cost converges to marginal cost as they produce more units. And we're going to go ahead and put a demand curve on here. And our demand curve, we'll do in blue, I guess, is going to look like this. It turns out, it's sort of a necessary mathematical fact, that if you have a nice linear demand curve like that, the marginal revenue curve always hits the x-axis halfway as far as the demand curve hits the x-axis. So our marginal revenue curve is going to look like that. So there's our marginal revenue curve. And I know the blue is a little bit hard to see here. So we find the profit maximizing quantity by looking at where the marginal revenue curve hits the marginal cost curve. All the units over here have marginal revenue above their marginal cost. So all of those units have a positive marginal profit. And in fact, the marginal profit is the distance between the marginal revenue curve and the marginal cost curve. This very unit right here has zero marginal profit because marginal revenue exactly equals marginal cost. All the units beyond that have marginal cost above their marginal revenue, so they're unprofitable to produce. So this intersection right here is our profit maximizing quantity. We'll see if black works any better. I think that's a little bit better. Okay, so that, we'll call it QM for the quantity that the monopolist chooses to produce. Now, we want to go ahead and try and figure out what the price and what the average total cost of production are. So we take this quantity, we look up here to the demand curve, and that is the price that the monopolist chooses to charge. And we take this quantity and look up to the average total cost curve, and that is the average total cost that the monopolist incurs when they produce this profit-maximizing quantity. So this bracketed term here is this vertical distance here, and quantity is the horizontal distance here. So that shaded box there is the monopolist's total profits. So that's total profit. Now, it's nice that the monopolist is making economic profits, and these are true profits in the sort of above and beyond opportunity cost sense, because we've already included all the relevant opportunity costs in our cost structure, because we know how to figure costs as economists using the opportunity cost of capital. what's going to be true here is that not only is the monopolist making economic profits, above average profits, but it's also going to be true here that we're going to have some deadweight loss. So we had deadweight loss before when we looked at price controls and tariffs and taxes and subsidies and that kind of stuff. But we're also going to have deadweight loss here. And in this case, it's going to be deadweight loss due to the private sector, just like it was with externalities. So when we have a market failure, like externalities or monopoly power, the unregulated private sector is going to produce deadweight loss. And in particular, there are trades out here beyond the monopoly quantity where the value that someone placed on the good, as given by the height of the demand curve, is above how much it would have cost to produce it. So producing this unit of Q out here would have generated gains from trade. And likewise out here. Now the monopolist doesn't produce those units because the monopolist, if it has to charge a uniform price, would make negative marginal revenue on those sales because it would end up cutting the price on all of its previous units and it would lose money. So the monopolist, at least in a simple example where the monopolist charges the same price to everybody, is not going to produce these. And this area out here is the deadweight loss due to monopoly pricing. And it's the area above the marginal cost curve and below the demand curve and to the right of the monopoly quantity. So this area, this triangle right here. And if we had a curvy demand curve or marginal cost curve, it wouldn't be a simple triangle, but that's what it's going to be in this case.